everyone, in this tutorial I am going to learn you how you can compress and uncompress an string, and this is very useful, and it is, you have seen a lot of compressed or zip programs in the internet, and you when you use a document which is very big, and to increase the spaces it take in your computer, you use a compress. You compress your file, and you must know how it works. For this, I have write a program that we are including the studio.h, and we are going to include limits.h, and I have declared three functions: bitprint, as we saw in previous tutorial, and we are going to pack or compress letters, and we are going to unpack what we have packed, and we are going to write it. In the pack of for characters, I have defined an integer p equals to A, which is implicitly conversion of character A to an integer, and put it in P. And I am going to shift P with bit char, which is 8. With 8 bits, I am going to push P to the left with 8 bits, which is char bit. And I am going to make a logical OR with variable B, which is the second character. And I am going to put the result in P again. And in next step, I am going again that push P to the left with 8 bits. And I am going to make it OR with C. As we've seen before, when we push to the left, we are going to push and it appears 0. And when we are going to push with the 8, all those everything here are going to appear here, and all of those bits are going to be 0. And when we make it OR with another value, then the value are appearing here, and what we have shifted is there already. And I'm going to put the result in P, and in next step I am going again to push P to the left with 8 bits and make it OR to D. Then we have get it A, B, C, D in all the in the first byte we have get it in the first byte we have get it D, and then C, and then B, and then A. When we are finished with all those things, we are going to return the variable P, which is an integer we have defined, and the function needs an integer as return. And in unpack, we are going to, I have defined a function by type of characters, and I am going to unpack that packed function, and I am going to pack it with 0, 1, 2, or 3, because we have 4 bytes, 4 bytes, 1, 2, 3, 4, that byte is 0, that byte is 1, that byte is 2, that byte is 3. That is because I use K 0, 1, 2, or 3. What is happening in the function? I am going to define an integer n equal k multiplied by 4 bit, which is 8. Then n is going to get a value 0, 8, 16, or 24, depending on which number you take it from the k. And I am going to use another variable, unsigned mask. It is an integer unsigned, and it is 255, which is 2 up to power to 16. It is 255. And I am going to push this max with n, either 0, either 8, either 16, or 24 bits. And I am going to return p, which is a parameter of the unpack function, p, make it logical and with that mask, and push it to the right with n. And as you know, it's going to take 1 byte as each step. This only give me 1 byte, means 1 character. 1 character, I take it here. The 0 is D. If K is 0, then N is 0, and P and mask is D, and we are going to push it to the right with 0, then it is character D. When K is 1, this is this byte, it is 8 byte, the N is 8, I am going to push mask with 8, and P and mask is going to take the 8, and I am going to push it back to 8 to the right, and it's character C. And if K is 2, it indicates byte 2, and the N is 16, and I am going to push mask 16, and I am going to end with P, and it's going to be the character B, and push it 16, and I am going to take the variable B. And if K is 3, N is 24, and when K is 3, it is the third byte, I'm going to push mask V24, and I am going to make an AND with mask, which indicates this one, what is in mask, is 111, and we are going to make it AND with P, which is the P value is appear because it is AND. And I am going to push the result V24, and I am going to get the A character. And in main program, I am going to define 4 characters and an integer n. And I am going to ask you to enter 4 characters. And in scanf, I am going to get 4 scan those 4 characters and put it in variable C8, C2, C3, C4 in their address. And I am going to call the pack function, which is integer return. It has an integer return, and I have defined n is equal pack of those 4 variables or 4 characters I have put it. And I am going to print those characters equal and bit print. We saw in previous tutorial how we print bit print a character or a variable in the or an integer in bit print, and I am going to put char, I am going to put a new line in the prompt, and after that I am going to see what is n is exactly, what has happened, what is the result of the packing. And I am going to unpack each character. Character C8 has the K number 3, it is byte 3, and the character C2 is replaced in byte 2, character 3 is replaced in byte 1, and character 4 is replaced in byte 0. When we compile this program, everything is okay, and I am going to run. I am going to use SBUX, and SBUX, this is S, this is B, this is U, and this is X. And the resulting of packing is that value. It is that value in integer 4. And when I am unpacking, the first is byte 3, it's byte 3 is S, then byte 2, which is B, then byte 1, which is U, and then byte 0, which is X. Okay, then you know when you want, when you compress your file or your meaning, then you know that it appear a lot of numbers, that when you are going to send your program to another place, it is packed, and if the hackers won't reach your program, they don't know what it stands. That is because in the all those downloading programs are zipped or compressed, and when you download, you uncompress and then you run the program. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.